Does anybody see what's wrong here? No? Okay, let's try over here. Does anybody see what's wrong here? No? Okay, I'll give you another try. Does anybody see what's wrong here? So I'm in my world. I'm in creative, just flying around, observing the damage. We've got world corruption. Yay. Yeah, so the other day I was like, I'm gonna play some Minecraft. Loaded in and my graphics display crashed, like not my graphics card, or maybe it was my graphics card, but it said my graphics display crashed, and I have two monitors. Both monitors just froze. I had a live stream on the other monitor. The sound was still playing, but it just froze, and I couldn't really do anything. Restarted the world. This was on load up of the world before anything loaded in, or before I could see anything, rather. I came back, and this is what happened. So, fortunately, it seems to have only... Let's just change the time since we're here in creative for a moment. It seems to have only affected areas that were rendered in immediately, because I was standing right about here when I loaded in, and I've flown off into the distance, and I don't seem to notice anything over here. The good news is that none of these chunks in the building were affected, or the windmill. Those would have been worst case scenarios. There's only four that I can see. Right here, which really only took out a wheat field and a little bit of a wall. I'm not worried about that. That's an easy fix. This one's probably the most obnoxious. It took out our house right here. And this appears to be from over here somewhere. That's the other thing. Some of them are... There are other chunks that just got shuffled around. And I did check in our lapis cave down here with all of our brewing stuff is safe. So that's fortunate. So this is really just a quick build fix. And over here, you can probably tell. Look down at this. Get a good look at it. Can you tell where it's from? It's actually this chunk over here. Right there. So some of the chunks actually got duplicated and moved somewhere. Instead of, I originally thought that maybe they swap places because this chunk belongs right here. That's the side of this building. this one's gonna be, I mean, it's just a matter of cutting everything down. And I guess I'll get a lot of stone out of it. I got some TNT saved up, so maybe I'd rather not mess with TNT around all these builds. So everything should be a fairly easy fix. And my last backup was from before I found my six wither skulls, before I fought the wither, and before I did a lot of mining. By the way, I changed the color of this glass. It was black. Now I changed it to there's some cyan and light blue. And I can look exactly in case any of you want to use this color. It looks like I've got green. I've got lime stained glass, cyan, and light blue. And that gives us this color, which is actually pretty nice. It blends into the sky, so it's not quite so noticeable, but it's also a pretty color. And this is definitely not permanent. This is a beacon that's going to get moved with us everywhere we go. Another thing that I want to talk about is we've been going back and forth on texture pack, right? So what I know for a fact that I want to do, you can see some wheat that I'm growing in still. What I know for a fact I want to do is whenever I come back here, I want to keep this in the John Smith texture pack. If I go somewhere else that was built in a different texture pack, if we go back to vanilla, like our next area, I'm planning on going to vanilla, then we'll go into vanilla when we go there. If we ever come back, we'll switch back just to get the feeling of how it was built. I'm considering possibly using a different texture pack for each area, each town. Is that something that's interesting to you guys? That would force us to, you know, utilize some different styles. I try to keep away from texture packs that are so wildly different that makes ugly blocks usable or turns blocks into something like diorite into crates or something. Obviously, that won't look good when you're mining, but also, you know, it's a little bit cheaty to me in the way that we're using it. This texture pack's pretty good in the way that it keeps default textures, the usable default textures usable, and the not so usable default textures are still pretty ugly in this texture pack. They're better looking, but I still tend to stray away from them. Other than that, I think our tree farm's all good. Yeah, everything else seems to be good. Just some little fixes here and there. I think I'm gonna go back into survival, and I'm gonna start with this bad boy right here. Maybe I should take a screenshot. Well, it's not like this road is anything too special. It's pretty random, so I don't need to duplicate it perfectly. And then this one's just gonna be a matter of removing this stone, removing this wall, and putting a layer of dirt and our road back in. So I'm gonna get started on this one. Oh man, that was fun. I'm sure glad I got the opportunity to fix that mistake. So I've fixed most of it. The sun's coming up here. I have fixed the two chunks over here. The one in the wheat field I did fix, and I haven't fixed the one over here. I don't know if we can see it from here. Hey, little zombie. Ah! Why don't I hear him hitting me? Hello? Is there something wrong with my sounds? Music's off? No, I can't hear. There's no sound. Oh, I'll be back. I didn't have my headphones plugged in all the way. Anyways, this is one chunk that was screwed up. You can tell where the edge of it is by, well, that happened, and the edge of this building got cut off. Hello, XP? Right here is where that big chunk was, and it's all gone, and this is my attempt to fill in, try to make it look natural. I think it looks pretty good. The only issue here, if I can find a way back up, is this is now a sunflower plains biome. The only difference that really makes is that the water color is different right there. And it's a little bit noticeable that it is a chunk shape. But other than that, I don't really care. It kind of just looks like a shadow from the dock right there. I don't know. That's a really long shadow. I had these set up because, oh man, I had this on haste 2, but I had to be right here to be able to get the haste 2 from it. So I'd run here, I'd run back, and I'd plow through everything. And then I filled up with water, and I had running water everywhere, like flowing water. And I actually did go into creative and fix that because that was getting a little obnoxious trying to fix that. That was tough. It wasn't that tough, but it was obnoxious. Hey, I will take you. I always collect gunpowder. Other stuff that I've done today. Can you tell I've been working on houses? Look at this. So before, the town pretty much stopped right here, and I had laid out a bunch of foundations for houses, And yeah, I've got 3 completed houses and then other houses that I've started on. This is really what they start out as. This, and then, you know, add the roof, add a few windows, add door, a few pillars like this. On some of them, I go in and add a side thing like this, which looks really nice. And there's a side entrance. I have to do interior still. But anyway, excuse me. I had to burp. That's looking a lot better. The point of this isn't so much... I've gone over how to make these houses lots of times. The point of this isn't so much how I made the houses or what they look like. It's more of the fact that we have more houses and it looks more like a town. Because before it was just kind of a group of houses right here. Now it's expanded a lot more. It's a quantity thing. And it does look pretty good to me. I think in our next area, there's going to be a lot more houses. But there's not going to be hay in them. It's not building the houses that's tough for me. You can see that I've practically built all the houses here. like this doesn't take much time. But this hay, you can see what I've been doing. Collecting lots of hay. Each one, it depends on the size, how much the hay they take up. So like this one, where there's 3 rows of hay, there's there. Let me see if I can get up here. There's 3 rows of hay on each side. There's right there, right there, and then there's the center one. So there's 2 on each side and 1 in the center. 5 rows in total. Every now and then, though, I make them extra wide. So this has 3 rows on each side plus the center. And that takes up actually a lot more. This one probably takes up about 40 hay blocks. This one over here probably takes over a stack. So, and they hay blocks aren't... I should have just, like, when I started making this place, made an underground wheat farm. An automated one. But now I'm nearing the end of the need of hay here, so no point now. What else? Yeah, everything here is looking pretty good. There is one more thing that I want to try here today. Let's see if I have the resources for it. Oh, of course I don't. What I want to address at the end of this episode would be red sheep. This right here. So ideally, it's almost nighttime. Great time to start recording. Ideally, this whole town would have been in the middle of plains. This all being plains biome would have been awesome. It's not. It's not horrible. It kind of just looks like a hill. It's extreme hills, but it doesn't look like mountains so much. That does. This kind of just looks like a hill. Over there is a forest. That's okay. You know, it's not like a swamp or anything. That would really not fit well. But at the same time, I kind of want to create a border to the city. And I'll tell you about that when I get rid of the music. Hello. Don't want you. Alright, so a while back, I was watching B-dubs. And it was the episode... I still hear it. It's off. Do you... Hello? Stop! Okay, I don't know how to stop music, apparently. He was doing his episode where he was doing outdoor stuff. And he did something that he didn't even talk about, but I noticed it. He made a border of trees on the edge of his wheat fields, and it kind of created a border, like boundaries to the city. And I kind of want to do that here if I can find a way. This is a really steep hill is the only problem. If we can find a way to do this. Let me think about this. All right, I'm slightly expecting this to not work. Because of the lack of room. Ooh, it did work. Okay, that's not a great tree, but we can work with it. I'll pretty these up in a moment. Let me just go ahead and get a few of them down. So that was like the most likely spot for it to work. So if we could create sort of a boundary like that for our trees, that'd be really nice. Ooh, that's really loud. I was messing with my block sounds and everything because I couldn't hear anything because I'm an idiot. So let's try another one. I want these to be fairly close. And the way that I have to put them on the outside, like towards the water, I think. So I might make them so that they're look like they're kind of leaning over the water. Good thing that I got so much bone meal from fighting those wither. Like, a lot of bone meal. Like, 5 stacks of bones or something, trying to get those wither skulls. So let's just take a step back. See, that creates a nice boundary. That one covers up, like, all of the hill, right? That's the idea that I'm going for here. So let me put down a few of these and we'll come back. Are you kidding me? Hello? What is going on here? My world's more corrupt than I thought. Will I have all my blocks back? Yeah. Alright, so I've done these trees. I've prettied them up a little bit. By the way, this is where I collect all my reed, and then I have a secret tunnel underneath my cow pasture that leads to a cow farm. That's where I get all my leather and stuff for books. Let's go to sleep, and then we'll take a look at it. It's a little underwhelming, to be honest. I think it's going to take either quite a bit of work. So this is just the start of it. Now, just looking at it up close, doesn't look to be anything special. The idea is that from far away, you get a sense of that's the edge of the town. Well, that's a bad way because you don't get a good view of it from there. But from here, I get that, I guess. I'm thinking that maybe, well, first of all, this thing's going to have to cover this entire hillside. And that didn't take too long. It did take me quite a bit of oak to make these custom. This tree's pretty pathetic. I'll probably have to go in and make that one up. Make them bigger in general, that might help. And also, I might have to do a second layer, like a second row up here, like plant a tree right here and see if that works. That might, because I can see the hill peeking over these trees, and I think that's kind of breaking something for me. But then, so this going all the way across this hill, we don't need to cross the back side of the town. What direction is north? That's south. We don't need it on the south side of town because we have a forest there. The north side has an ocean or water or a lake, whatever. And this side, it could work on. Let's go over there. It's really just a lot of wheat field, and I've been working on this still. You can see where I've planted more wheat. I have yet to add in my walls and stuff, but I have been expanding it here. So, you know, we could bring the wheat up to, like, around here. That'd be a lot of wheat field, and then do a similar tree line. Leg spike. I get leg spikes over there especially often because I have so many cows there. I should probably kill them off. I'm not sure what did it here. Probably just loading in new chunks. It's not new chunks, but rendering in some chunks. To help with the tree line, we could probably do, like, double tall grass. This would take up a lot of bone meal. I am planning on, in the next base, which, get excited, I'm making plans for it. I'm not sure if we're going to finish this place before we start going over there or not. I kind of want to mix things up a little bit. But, ooh, there goes my air conditioning. I hope you can't hear that too much. I'm going to put a mob farm in there, I think. Do a little bit more quality of life things other than just building in there. But anyways, you know, this would have been a really good mob farm. Right there. Hide one in there. Should have thought about that. And we can also do our stone walls at the base of these trees. And that would help define the boundaries really well too, I think. And it would look nice. But anyways, that's it for today. I have been spending a lot of time doing lots of stuff off camera. I'm enjoying this game. It's fall break for me. Having a lot of fun. It's actually like 11 in the morning. I'm finishing this episode up. And I'm probably going to start right on the next episode. Right when I stop recording. So, thank you for watching, everybody. That thing doesn't go up all the way. It should peter out a little bit more. That looked cool. Alright, I was saying bye. Bye!